All right, guys, it's Pasty Boy. Sorry I've been away so long. We're actually going to give this a shot today. We're going to try to do a Harley. It's not going to be so much a moto vlog. I'm going to try to record the riding as best I can, and then I'll probably I'll do a voiceover after I've recorded it in post. So let me just show you what we're working with here for the first ride. I guess I tried to do what I had in mind for a front view hooked up to the full face, even though I don't wear a full face normally when I ride, but in this case I'd have to get a front view. So let me show you what we're working with today. So obviously here's my bike. It's a 2008 Harley Sportster XL Low 1200. Bought it brand new in 08. There's a few videos of it on my channel. Hopefully we'll see more of it this summer. So I've got my modular Ski-Doo helmet here, my old one. As you know, now I have that yellow one I bought. And I've got the GoPro Hero 7 Black hooked up to it. So it's going to be a left side view, and you'll be able to see when I turn my head left, but you won't be able to see right when I turn right. You'll see sort of right. And I've got my bag here, so I'm going to bring in this handheld that I'm using right now, which is my good HD camera. Not the one that I bring snowmobiling, the little HD camera. But anyway, so long story short, we're gonna go for a ride today, see what we can record. I'll try to point out some stuff and I'll try to narrate that in post. All right, we're gonna keep it local today, so hope you enjoy this. Let me know what you think. So as you can see, they're resurfacing the road here right out in front of my street, and it's going to be mint once it's done. It really wasn't horrible to begin with, but it's good to see that the town's being proactive and keeping up with the street maintenance. So I kind of grew up in this general area my entire life. This business here to the left was the family business a few years back. It was a feed store turned into a pet food center, and actually ran the store for a little while after my brother didn't want to do it anymore. Not Mark, though, my other brother. Here's a local plumber that got big and successful. He's probably retired now because he's an old man on my dad's age. And we're going to make a left up here, the next street. As you can see, the street has been milled here, so if any of you guys are riders, you know how it feels to ride on something with this texture, or say a steel deck bridge or whatever, your wheel starts getting a little squirrely there. But you really shouldn't have any issue. It just feels like everything's out of control, but you tend to maintain control. Coming up here on the left, this plowed field used to be a large apple orchard, and to the right, more farming, and this dilapidated barn used to say apples on it and point to this building here across the street where they did some processing and sales and things. It was really nice while it lasted. Now that I think about it, this field to the left also was an apple orchard for sure, because this house coming up on the left has still four apple trees there, and they figured might as well put some apples in for themselves, I guess. I don't know. But those are the only apple trees left now, all of these years later. Now, you can't tell now, but last year this street was resurfaced, where they just spray like tar onto the surface and a coat of stones, and then as the cars drive over it, it packs it down, and now you can't tell. It just looks like a nice smooth resurfaced street, but it really, you can't ride on it when that first happens, because then you just get your whole bike sprayed with the loose stones that haven't adhered yet. The houses that we just passed back up to the Erie Canal, and they actually have like waterfront, I guess you could call it, property there. Some of them even have docks and things, but it's kind of nice, even though it's just a canal, to have the water right there, because you can boat in the Erie Canal. And now we're going to cross this bridge here that goes over the canal. We'll see if we can catch a little glimpse of what it looks like from up here. Not sure what kind of view we're going to get while on the bike. Probably not much. Okay, I just skipped ahead about a half mile here. We're going to turn left onto this street, and this is actually the street that I grew up on from the time I was 10 years old, or almost 11, until I got married, pretty much. I actually lived with my parents for another year and a half after I got married, because I got married fairly young, and the house was pretty large. And I'll show you that in a second here. Coming up on the left here, but it's kind of hard to see. New owners planted a lot of shrubbery and whatnot, but there it is with the large three-car garage. Things, we didn't have it landscaped like that, but it's a big house. Not a great view of it, but whatever. If you guys want to see it a little better, maybe I'll drive by it again another time. And on the right here is my aunt's house, where she actually still lives. Another big house. And Shag's dad lives down here on the right. I saw a ton of development go on in this area, especially on my street growing up, since 1983, I'd say, is when we moved in. We were the seventh house on the left originally, and now it's, you can't even count anymore. There's been developments built within the deep properties that go by and everything, so it's just a really booming area, and the properties have kind of gotten out of control price-wise recently, to the point where I don't even want to build or buy a house in this area anymore, because the taxes are outrageous. So we'll see what happens. Now, you won't be able to see it, but my elementary school is coming up here on the left. There's homes in front of it, which is strange, because normally when they build schools, they buy all the homes and tear them down. But this was built, I don't know, quite a while back, and they probably decided it was cheaper to just put a driveway around these homes and build a school behind it. I'm going to cut it off here. We'll call this part one, and pick it up from here in the next video. So I'll give you the little outro that I recorded when I got done with this ride completely. I don't want to make it too long of a video, so we'll break it up a little bit. Let me know what you guys think, and here we go to the outro. All right, guys, just got back from the ride, 22.6 miles. If it's too long, I might chop out some little segments, but I'm going to try to narrate and make this story interesting, which I'm saying after the fact. Hope you liked it. If there's something you want me to do or say or whatever in these type of videos, because this is a little bit different, you know, snowmobiling videos, you just ride, and then when you get done, you try to describe what you did, where this is kind of taking a route, and then I'm trying to point out things in the area. This is my local area, Rochester, New York, and home of like Kodak and other big companies like that, where Kodak is not much anymore, but at the same time was the birthplace of it. Our airport is actually in my hometown here. I'm like so close. It's a great thing. It's a small international airport too. But, you know, let me know what you think of this first moto vlog, if you will. Leave a comment down below. Please thumb up the video if you liked it. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for sticking around.